If you're currently suffering from pain on the outside or lateral aspect of your hip and not sure where it's coming from, this is the video for you. Welcome back, everyone. My name is Zach Greenway, your performance sport and spine in Seattle, Washington. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how you can accurately and concisely figure out where your pain is coming from, whether it's your hip joint itself, the glute tendons, or your low back or lumbar spine. Stick around as we show you how to figure out this quickly and accurately. If you look at our model of our spine to kind of familiarize ourselves with different terms. So we got our low back or our lumbar spine, which is the five bones vertebrae. And these white things are the bones, the yellow things are the nerves, and the clear things between the bones are called your disc. But for our purposes, we're gonna count this as one unit or structure. Below that, we got the pelvis and the sacrum. Now here is your hip joint. So it's the ball and socket joint. So this is the second structure we're gonna focus on, is the hip joint. On the outside of this is the greater trochanter, so this is going to be important. And then lastly, this purple band is your gluteal tendon, which is the last structure. So these, one of these three things is probably causing your hip pain that we're going to go into next to figure out how it works. So for those that haven't watched our videos before, the way this is going to be laid out is we're going to go over each of those topics separately and give you what's most important to focus on or most clinically relevant. And at the end of the section, there'll be a clickable link in the upper right hand that will bring you to the video to help address that with the best exercises. Now, one thing to note is it's more than just one thing. You can't just say, oh, I have pain on the outside of my hip, it must be this. But if you say, oh, I have pain on the outside of my hip, I'm over 50, it hurts worse in the morning, and I have lost range of motion, that's much more likely to be hip arthritis. So after you go through this, you hopefully you can be like, oh, wow, I have three or four or five of these findings, so you can be more confident that you know what you're dealing with. First thing we're going to cover is gluteal tendinopathy, or more commonly known as gluteal tendinitis, that purple band. So there's irritation or degeneration to that band. This is most common in women postmenopausal, but anyone can get it. So it's not exclusively just to that category. So typically this is lateral pain or that greater trochanter. Sometimes it can radiate into the buttocks or down the leg. In some severe cases, it actually can go into the lower leg. What makes this worse? So this is worse with laying on the affected side, sitting cross-legged. Prolonged sitting can irritate it, and as you get up and move around, it can be painful but get a little better. Single leg loading exercises like stairs and then walking, especially prolonged distances or uphill. With this condition, you have normal hip range of motion, and we put this one first of the three because we have these four tests that we're gonna cover next. And if you have a positive finding on all four, there's a 99% chance you have this condition. So the first one is single leg stance at 30 seconds. When you do this, does it reproduce pain or cause weakness in that hip? The next is testing for those hip abductor muscles, the muscles on the outside of your hip. Are they weak compared to the other side? Now you can manually press on them, but that can be hard to do on your own. So one thing you can do is just lay on your side and raise the good leg up 10 times and then compare that to the painful side. If it's much harder, that's positive. The next is a FADIR test. And this is an orthopedic test of the hip to put tension on that tendon. And if it reproduces your pain on that side of the hip, it's positive. And the last is just palpation or pressing on that greater trochanter or that big bone on the outside of your hip. If all four of these are positive, again, it's very likely that you have this. Two things to note here, just pressing on that bone is not enough. Sometimes people say, oh, there's tenderness on that hip. It must be this condition. You've got to collaborate it with those other three tests. And then the other thing is, often this lateral hip pain gets diagnosed or misdiagnosed as gluteal bursitis, inflammation of that bursa. And if you've been diagnosed with that, you're probably struggling because you're not getting better. Here's a video we made on that. And the short synopsis is that isolated bursitis is very rare. Only about 2 to 8% of people have that without tendon issues. So if you're having that, click that link and you'll be educated on how to get that better. Next is hip osteoarthritis or hip OA. And that affects that ball and socket joint that we talked about earlier. And this is either deep anterior hip pain or a C-spine pain where your hand is on the side of your hip, but it can radiate into the outside or lateral aspect of your hip or down your leg into the front. And since it's affecting the joint itself, this is worth with challenging at end range. So when you're doing things like stairs or sitting and you're kind of pushing that ball into the socket, that can really irritate it. And the four cardinal signs of this are difficulty putting on shoes and socks, difficulty sitting on the floor, difficulty getting in and out of your car, and then a loss of range of motion compared to the other side. Another thing about this is with arthritis in general, it's typically worse in the morning, and as you move around, it should get better within 30 minutes. For tests, the FADIR test is the best test, where we're kind of pushing that ball into the socket. Now, it's really good if it's negative. If it's negative, you mean confident you don't have arthritis. If it's positive, it just means something's wrong and you should get x-rays to look for arthritic changes to confirm that diagnosis. And then lastly, the low back or the lumbar spine, those bottom five joints of your spine. Now, this is the easy to differentiate because you're gonna also have back symptoms, back pain or back tightness, as well as lateral hip pain. Now, this may radiate into your leg as well, but you're gonna have that back symptom. This can be worse with prolonged sitting and loading your back. So like lifting things or twisting, as well as spinal range of motion. So bending forward, bending to the side should reproduce your symptoms. And also with this one, your hip range of motion can be normal. So for gluteal tendinopathy in this one, you have normal hip range of motion. The middle one, or hip OA, is the only one that has less range of motion. So that's an important characteristic to be aware of. Imaging is not as important with this. It's more to rule out serious pathology. So if you don't have leg pain, no x-rays are needed. If you have leg pain, you may want imaging. Summary, gluteal tendinopathy or tendinitis, there's lateral hip pain that may radiate down the leg. The pain is worse laying on the painful side with prolonged sitting or single leg loading exercises. And when you get up from sitting, the pain is often worse and you have normal hip range of motion. For hip OA or osteoarthritis, there's deep hip or groin pain or the C sign. The stiffness is worse first thing in the 30 minutes and gets better. This is the only one that has lost range of motion and you have difficulty putting on your shoes or socks, sitting on the floor, or sitting cross-legged. Lastly, the lumbar spine or low back. This is the only one that has back pain or stiffness associated with the hip pain. It's worse with spine loading or bending and with prolonged sitting, and this one has normal hip range of motion.